Hey guys, it's Monika. You know, sometimes we are inspired by other content creators, and sometimes when the inspiration hits us, we may not quite know what it's going to look like in the end. And I've had a couple of weeks of inspiration, and I'm not there yet. I mean, I haven't completed my journey of inspiration, so to speak. But, you know, I was in Exeter, in my Exeter office, and I went out for a walk along the river. And the walk was absolutely gorgeous. The river is beautiful. The tide was in. It's the salt water. It goes out to the ocean. The tide was in, and there was nobody around. There's just like maybe a few people on the river path. But I walked all the way down to the end, and then I decided I was going to walk up the street. And when I walked up the street, I saw a shop that I hadn't noticed before. And I've walked this path before, this walk, but most of the time I just go back along the water rather than going up the street. But for some reason, I was inspired to go up the street. And I saw the shop and I saw the mannequin outside the shop window. And immediately it said to me, this is gotta be a type of store that Susan, AKA Little Poet, would love. And so I went in and I just took a few little clips here, but the whole entire shop was full of the most amazing vintage pieces. And as I was walking around, I said, what would Susan do with this shop? What would she say about this? Would this inspire her music? You know, she's got a beautiful voice and she does the most amazing music. And of course, I can't sing. I don't have any musical ability at all. But I was just mesmerized by the beauty of the shop and the vintage pieces. And I kept thinking of Susan. And I still don't know where I'm gonna go with the clips. I'm gonna go back to the shop. I'm gonna film some more. They said I could do that. And maybe I'll try on some of the hats or just, you know, look at the jewelry a little closer. But I couldn't help but think of Susan Little Poet as I walked through the shop. I pictured her in my mind's eye. And I pictured her looking at the jewels and looking at the hats and looking at the shoes and just looking at everything in the shop. And all I could picture was a big smile on her face. And I kept saying to myself, what would her camera record if she was here? It made me happy. It also inspired me. So I filmed in there a little bit, but it inspired me to try to get a little bit better with my storytelling. So that's going to be one of my channel goals, is to try to get a little bit better with my storytelling. There is no way that I'm going to be Susan Little Poet ever, but she inspires me. And so I'm going to try to achieve to be a little bit better with storytelling. The other person that inspired me recently, and this was probably about a month or so ago. Some people love the Wig Talk, some people don't. I wear wigs in a lot of my videos. I find that they are an awesome fashion accessory. It also makes it super easy for a content creator to film a video. And it's just an easy process. So I have been reviewing and talking about wigs. And I'm not a professional wig reviewer. I'm not at all like some of the women that I watch that really know the product inside and out. I'm sort of probably more like you are, or, you know, more of an average person just playing around with alternate hair and hair accessories and loving it. So I had an opportunity, the very first opportunity I had ever to do any wig reviews was a company called Uniwigs, and they had sent me about 2 years ago a number of wigs. So recently watching Taz's video, she did. Now Taz's wig closet, if you don't know who that is, and I'm sure if you're not into wigs, you might not be, but I'll tell you, this woman is absolutely beautiful. She also does some fashion. She also talks a little bit about skincare, and she does review her wigs beautifully. So I'm gonna link her channel below, of course, as well as Little Poet, in case you're not familiar with her, which would be unbelievable if you weren't. But anyways, I'm going to link their channel below because both these women have inspired me recently. And Taz in particular, she did a series on the summer short looks. And she modeled a bunch of different wigs. And I said, wow, I said, you know what? I've got a number of wigs from Uniwigs that I could show people. Uniwigs is an affordable wig. They have many different styles, and I thought, I'm gonna pull them out and look at them again. So I did this kind of like little video, clips, and I put them together, and I talked about the wigs. So I decided I would reach out to the Uniwigs, the LaVivid Collection. I would reach out to the person that had sent me the wigs originally and ask if the coupon code was still good, because I figured if I was gonna talk about the wigs, I would, you know, obviously, would like the coupon code to still be good. And so he said, yeah, absolutely. And he said, we'll give you a new code. And he goes, how about you try a new wig? So I went, oh, okay. So I really wanted to try one that was more like a page boy. And for whatever reason, they weren't willing to send that one. And that's okay. So he said, how about you try Lisa? It's a very, very popular look, and it's a short, and it would fit perfectly with the summer do. And I said, well, you know, I've had Lisa. I love Lisa. I have Lisa in Almond Frost. And he said, well, we'll send it to you in a different color. So I picked a different color, but they were all out. And so he suggested the color, and it's actually called Maple Swirl. And I was a little hesitant because I didn't think it would be my color, but they sent me the wig. They sent me the wig. And as you can see here from me opening up the box on the wigs, it came beautifully packaged. But I want to show it to you before I put it on my head so that you can see what the wig looks like. So this is Maple Swirl, this is Lisa. And for me, this is a blonder look. Now this is totally unaltered. I just am shaking her up. I'm not doing anything to this wig at all. It is your traditional cap. It is not a monofilament. There is no lace front. Just very much a traditional cap, very, very comfortable on. This is an extremely affordable wig, and right now with the coupon code and the sales, it really is affordable. So I'm gonna put this on so that you can see this color wig, Maple Swirl, with the rooted look, so you can see it on me, which I think for me is too bright of a color, but I wanted you to see it. So I'm gonna put it on, and then at the very tail end, I'm gonna put all the clips of all the other Uniwigs that I have worn over the last 2 to 3 years. I did get a dark brown one that I had given away, and then I had my favorite is definitely gonna be Patsy, and I'll put Patsy on again at the end of the video, but when I come back, I'm gonna be wearing this one just so you can see what Lisa looks like in this color, if you're interested. If not, hang around anyways. All right, so this is Lisa. Now this is totally unaltered. I would probably use a little bit of dry shampoo to bring down some of the shine. I think you can probably all see the shine that I'm talking about. And I probably, if I were to wear this for myself, I probably would tone down the brighter blonde, because to me this is too gold for me. So I'm gonna turn so that you can see what this looks like in the back. So anyways, Lisa. Maple Swirl. I love the cut. I think the, you know, the shorter cut in the summer, I mean, this is perfect. You can put this on. It fits really wonderful. You can put this on. You can go out and about. It's a very, very affordable look. And I think because of the permatease up here, whether or not you have a monofilament and, you know, you can, or a lace front, you know, I mean, you can get away without having that. And you can, even though it's not a monofilament, you could actually part this if you wanted. You can train it to be parted whichever side you really feel more comfortable. So this was sent to me because I asked about a coupon code. This wig sent to me from the LaVivid Collection. Designer Collection, Unique Alternative Hair. So if you like this warmer blonde with the gold and the dark roots, and you're looking for an affordable piece, I think this might be an option for you. So now I'm going to put on Patsy, my favorite, and that's an almond frost. I think why I like this one a lot is that it is, it's a little bit longer. It's a little bit more of, I'll turn around. You can see it's a little bit more of a shaggy look, which I think I really like. So this is the color that I like a lot on me, Almond Frost. I think this is a really great color. And I'll put this color side-by-side comparison so you can see the difference in the gold tones. I don't know if you can see, but in the gold tones of the Maple Swirl. What do you think? So anyways, I just, you know, was, like I said, inspired by Taz, who showed all the summer looks, and I said, well, I can act on the inspiration that Taz gave me. The inspiration that Susan Little Poet gave me, I'm going to have to work on a while, because I have a lot of ideas, but I just haven't put them, I haven't put them into action yet. But with Taz, I did have these short wigs, and I was able to demo this. And then when Andy from Uniwigs said, hey, you know, I'll send you another one to show, I said, sure, why not? So this will give someone who is on the fence about the color an idea about what this color really looks like. So that's my sort of fun little wig. So anyways, I'm going to go ahead and insert the clip so you can see the different wig looks that I had from Uniwigs. All of these were sent to me courtesy in exchange for a demo, you know, and I really hate to even say a review because I'm not a wig reviewer, but they were sent to me courtesy to demonstrate them, to show them what they look like on for my viewers. And I think they look pretty good. And again, I have a coupon code for Uniwigs. Anything off of their website that you might like. And these are just really cute little summer wigs, I think. Very, very comfortable on. This one, like I said, this is Patsy. And Patsy is actually, I believe, my favorite. Thank you all so much for watching, guys.